For today's tutorial, I'm starting out by applying this Too Faced Hangover X Primer all over to hydrate my skin and prep it for foundation. I'm also going to use this Tarte Clean Slate Smoothing Primer on the T-zone area of my skin. This fills in any pores to give a smoother look to the skin. Now taking NARS Sheer Glow Foundation in the shade Barcelona, I'm going to dot this on my face firstly using my finger. Then I'm going to take a damp Beauty Blender sponge to apply all over. This has been my favourite way to apply foundation lately. I really like how it gives a dewy glowing finish to my skin by using the sponge damp, and I also find it makes my dry skin look more luminous. For concealer, I'm using the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in the colour Custard, and I've applied that under my eyes, on the corners of my nose, my forehead and chin. These are the areas I want to brighten and cover any redness. I'm using this highlight pen by MAC in the shade Light Boost to highlight my face. This is a yellow colour which is great for brightening up the skin. I like to apply it along the tops of my cheekbones, under my eyes to further brighten any dark circles, down the bridge of my nose, on the chin and forehead. This will bring these features forward and add lift to my cheekbones. Now to add more dimension to my face, I'm first using a cream bronzer. This is the Chanel Soleil de Tan bronzer on a MAC 139 flat synthetic brush to bronze up my skin. I'm applying that in the hollows of my cheekbones, across my forehead and temples, and also along the jawline, blending down the neck. This is an important step as it will make sure your face and neck are matching in colour. I really like using a synthetic brush for cream products as it applies the product quite lightly, allowing you to build up the intensity of colour that you're wanting. I'm also going to lightly contour the sides of my nose. Now we're going to set everything we did on the face with powder. I'm using the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, and first taking the yellow highlight shade called Lyric to set all the areas of my face I highlighted. The brush I'm using is also from Kat Von D that you can get to use with this palette. Taking the warmer brown shade called Shadow Play, I'm setting the areas where I bronzed up my skin. I'm using the angled side of the brush for this as it fits perfectly in the hollows of the cheekbones and for contouring the nose, whereas the oval end is perfect for setting under the eyes and the centre of the face. Taking the cooler brown shade called Subconscious on a NARS Eater brush, I'm contouring my cheeks and forehead. You want to use a cool brown shade with a grey undertone as this resembles a shadow and gives a more natural contoured look. Now to add some more glow to the skin, I'm using this cream colour base from MAC in the colour Shell to highlight the tops of the cheekbones, down the bridge of the nose, tip of the nose, and the Cupid's bow. I'm using a cream blush for this look today in a beautiful mauve colour. This is MAC Have a Lovely Day Casual Colour Lip and Cheek Colour. This is going to complement the mauve tones we're using on the eyes and lips as well. To add even more of a glow, I'm using Becca Opal Highlighter with a Zoeva fan brush. I wet the brush with MAC Fix Plus. This gives a more intense highlight to look like you are glowing from within. Using Fix Plus spray again to set all the face products and bring out the highlights even more. Moving on to brows, I'm using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dick Brow Pomade in the colour Chocolate. This gives a very defined and filled in look to the brows. I'm using the Anastasia Dual Ended Brow Brush. I first use the spoolie to comb through my brows, then with the angle brush I'm lining underneath the brow, then going along the top of the brow to outline the shape I want. Next, I lightly fill in the front, then the rest of the brow as well. I comb through the brows again to make sure the product is evenly placed along the brows. Then to set in place, I'm using this MAC Pro Longwear Waterproof Brow Set in the shade Quiet Brunette. Moving on to the eyes, I'm taking MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot as my eyeshadow base, applying this all over the lid and carving out my brows as well. To set the base, I'm mixing these two colours, Free Spirit and Supermom from the Tartlet palette. Taking a MAC 224 brush and the colour Natural Beauty, I'm blending this along my crease, back and forth in windshield wiper motions. This colour acts as a transition shade, which allows the darker colours I'm using to blend out easier. With a Morphe M441 brush, I'm taking the colour Best Friend and applying this in the outer V and inner corners of my eyes, leaving the centre blank. This gives a more rounded effect to the eyes. Next, taking this Makeup Geek foiled shadow called Grandstand, I'm placing this in the very centre of the lid to give a spotlight effect. These foiled eyeshadows are crazy pigmented, I didn't even need to wet my brush before applying it. It gives a beautiful shine on the lid. I'm taking a clean blending brush to blend those colours together on the edges. To add some more depth, I'm taking this beautiful dark mauve shade called Mauveless by MAC, and I'm blending this along the top of my crease, connecting the outer V and inner corners of my eyes. Using a MAC 219 pencil brush, I'm taking the colour Natural Beauty and smudging that along the lower lash line. With a MAC 212 flat shader, I'm picking up Grandstand, using this to highlight in the centre of the lower lash line to add a bit more sparkle. Taking Mauveless on that same pencil brush, I'm adding this to the outer and inner corners of the eyes. I'm applying a few coats of Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara to my top lashes. For false lashes today, I chose these Coco lashes in the number 107. These are quite natural, flirty looking lashes that are perfect for this look. Using this MAC Nude Eyeliner, I'm lining my waterline. For a highlight, I'm using the Becca Opal Highlighter in the inner tear ducts of the eyes and also along the brow bone. Apply MAC Giga Black Lash Mascara to the bottom lashes to complete the eyes. For the lip colour, I wanted a beautiful mauve purple colour to complement the makeup, so I'm using the NARS Audacious Lipstick in the colour Anna. This is the final look. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you in my next video.